whom the gods would destroy, they first make mad. There's an old Latin saying, and the title of this next installment of Star Trek. We're about to land at an insane asylum on a planet called Elba 2. There, we'll meet a once brilliant military leader driven to lunacy, who now wants to conquer and rule the known universe. If this conjures up images of Napoleon in exile, it was intentional on the parts of the writers Lee Irwin and Jerry Sowell. Perhaps our fascination with insanity lies in the distorted images we see of ourselves. The evil we might do, the greatness we might strive for, the freedom we might feel. In madness, we may see our other selves, the ones that live just below the surface. Now, whom gods destroy. Yvonne Craig, who plays Marta in this episode, was better known as Batgirl in the classic Batman television series. And Key Luke, who portrays Governor Corey in this installment, had quite the film and television career, with roles ranging from the classic The Good Earth to early Charlie Chan movies. But his most famous role was the blind Master Poe, who taught Grasshopper the finer points of martial arts in the television series Kung Fu. If you're getting the impression that Star Trek was giving its children hand-me-down clothes, you're right. In Whom Gods Destroy, Marta's costume was a pared-down version of Venus Slave Girl ensemble from The Cage, and the spacesuits from the Tholian Web make their reappearance together with Dr. Adams' robe. And the neural neutralizer chair is familiar from Daggers of the Mind. Between the skimpy budgets and declining ratings, we were quickly becoming aware that the end was near.